Here we are on the Make It Happen Network discussing strategy number 5, get focused. Woo! So, what is focus?
Oh, wow, Richard. Well, you got me focused already. Focused is clarity. Focus is seeing your dream with the right vision, which obviously we talked about in a previous strategy. But it's clarity of about what it is that you want, okay? It's following what it is that you want. So many people think they know what they want in life. But if they really ask specifically what it is that they want out of life, they're all over the place. They're bouncing all over the place. The next day, yes, they bounce all over. Oh, it'd be nice to have this. Be nice to have. It'd be nice to do this. Be nice to go there. Well, there's a lot of things that'd be nice. But what do you really want out of life? Mm-hmm. And are you willing to make the sacrifices? And that's an ugly word too. Mm-hmm. To get what it is that you want out of life, you've got to stay focused on it. Every leading business person that I have read about, that I have come to know, or that has been affiliated with me, all will tell you, if they've ever been successful before, they got there through being focused. And if they ever lost it and had to come back, it's because they lost their focus. Mm-hmm. It's not about where you're at, it's about where you're going. Okay? And where we're going is what our focus is, because a lot of times we're flowing along in life and we're wanting to head a certain way, but we're not there. We're in another place, we're in a horrible place, and we just lose the focus because it just seems like we've lost hope. Mm. And that's what basically focus is keeping our eyes on the ball. It's keeping the clarity there about where it is that we want to go.
Focus. Follow one course until successful.
Very good.
I love that. Follow one course until successful. Talk to us a little bit about how literally losing focus can cause people to fail in their business, even in their life.
Does it all the time, basically. It does it all the time. They take their eyes off of what it is that they wanted. It'd be like me playing basketball on a basketball goal. And I decide I don't want to look at the goal anymore. I'm just going to start throwing the ball. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not going to make any baskets doing that. Okay, mm-hmm. If I'm a quarterback and I'm not focused on the receiver who's going to be able to catch that ball, I'm not going to make any successful passes. Okay? I have to stay focused on that. I tell a story in the book about focus, Ridge, and I'll try to narrow it down. But it's a story about someone I knew that went to one of these driving courses that paid big money to learn how to race these race cars. And he had a person in the other seat that actually could overpower him in driving. But they taught him what to do, got him driving. He said, "Now, what I want you to do is you keep your eyes where you want to go, not where you're going. Keep them where you want to go." He starts going around the track. The fellow who was on the other side started to put him into a tailspin. What did he do? He started looking where he was going instead of where he wanted to go. The guy reached over, grabbed his face, turned it back the other way. He said, "I said, look where you want to go, not where you're going." That happened 2 or 3 times. Finally put him in a spin. He started to look the other way and his car came right out of the spin and he started going straight. Why do you think it is that people run off a road? There's one lonely tree out in the middle of a field, and they head straight for that tree. Okay? They're looking at where they're going, not where they want to go. All right? Mm-hmm. We've got to keep our eyes focused on where it is that we're wanting to go, because all along the way, we're going to be hitting those obstacles. They're going to be rising up.
And what can we do to stay not in the moment of what it is that I'm doing right now, where I am at this particular point, but committed and focused to where it is that I want to go? What are some strategies, some specific something? Because that sounds hard.
Originally, it's very hard. And the strategies, although they're not hard, are, you know, they're a little bit lengthy. We've got exercises we've got to help people get through that. But all along the way, if I know what I want and I want it bad enough and I'm hungry for it, really hungry for it, then I'll learn to keep my eyes on the ball. The thing is, we get back to that word commitment. I have to commit to what it is that I want to change. I have to stay focused on that, and I have to work my way through the obstacles. And you just have to realize that part of accomplishing whatever it is we want to accomplish, part of life in and of itself, is that things just aren't going to go your way all the time. They're just not going to do it. The people who make it to the other side, and a lot of us only see the other side. We see somebody say, oh, look at the great car, the big house. We don't see everything they went through to get to that. Mm-hmm. And we don't see everything they're going through to keep that. Okay? If I'm going to get where it is I want to go, I've got to keep my eyes on that ball. And from a strategy standpoint, originally it takes not just the focus itself in the Word, but it takes visualization, it takes it being in my heart, it takes me meditating on it, it takes me believing in myself to be able to get to where it is I want to go and keep that focus. Because when somebody tries to take my hope away, if I don't believe in me, and I have to believe in them believing in me, I never will make it.
Well, and that's why there are 14 strategies, because they all do work together. It's not that one is isolated.
They're all cohesive.
Now, this particular strategy is get focused. It's not just focus. In other words, there's a step there that's an active action word. So how do we, for the people who are sitting there watching this video and they're saying, well, that sounds really good, how do I get focused?
Well, Ridge, I would just say this. Obviously, as you said, all 14 work together. That's why it's not a one strategy book. And before I answer that, I'll say it's almost like learning mathematics and teaching somebody some advanced algebra course first without learning all the basic math to get to that point. All these strategies work together. In order for me to get focused, I have to commit and change. I have to have a vision. I have to affirm my passion. All of these things have to work together for me to be able to focus and stay focused and understand how to overcome obstacles, understand how to overcome financial setbacks, understand what financial setbacks are, maybe how to avoid many of them. All of that has to work together for me to be able to stay focused and to get focused in the first place. Because otherwise I can say, hey, Ridgely, think about what you want, put your eyes on it, stay there, and you're thinking, okay, that sounds great. It means nothing without all of those things working through. That's why it's so important for everyone to understand each strategy and then be able to tie those strategies together through the proper coaching.
Well, I thought I could just maybe, you know, take a pill or something and I'm kind of done. Is that not happening in this new millennium?
Most of the world kind of thinks that. They just take a pill and it'll all be fine. But it doesn't work that way, Rich. It doesn't. Whether I visualize and dream or whatever it may be and be focused on what I want, focus without action is basically going to end up being worthless. Mm-hmm. People can say what they want to say, try to mislead you in ways that they want to mislead you. But if I sit on the couch and say, okay, I'm focused, I want, and I say all these positive affirmations, I may feel better, but I'm still not going to accomplish those things unless I'm willing to get up and put it into action. And that's one of the things that I think is so important about what we teach. We teach all of the strategies, but then we want to teach you how to put that into action and actually make it happen in your life.
Mm-hmm. Which is why we call this the Make It Happen Network. So you mean if I start visualizing and I really, really focus, I'm still not going to get a pearl necklace?
Probably not. Now, you know, maybe you're that rare person that the publisher sweepstake rings your doorbell. I don't know. I just wouldn't want to teach people to sit on the couch and wish for the publisher's clearinghouse to ring their doorbell, okay? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So the answer to that is probably not.
And we wouldn't want to teach that, because we know that for the person who makes the commitment and who gets the right habits, affirms their passion, and does all the other things that we're teaching through the Make It Happen Network, this is a guarantee, whereas that is just a roll of the dice.
Absolutely.
So that's strategy number 5, get focused.